So welcome back to all of you. Let us start the solution of non-homogeneous linear differential equation. As we know, the general form of non-homogeneous linear differential equation is dny by dx to the power n plus p1 dn minus 1y by dx to the power n minus 1 plus dotted up to pn y equal to x. This is known as linear differential equation. And which is your right hand side is a function that is capital S. So that's why this is known as non-homogeneous linear differential equation. Okay, so its complete solution is y equals to CF plus PI that have been discussed in our previous class. Okay, that means if your right hand side equals to 0, that is known as homogeneous, and the homogeneous solution is only CF, y equals to CF. If it is non-homogeneous, means right hand side x is not equal to 0, means it has a function that is known as non-homogeneous, and non-homogeneous solution is y equal to CF plus PI. Complete? So then come to working procedure for solving linear differential equation. That means we have to know the solution of linear differential equation, means non-homogeneous linear differential equation. So any questions will be there, any differential equation will be there. Non-homogeneous means right hand side function is present. So at that time, these are the procedure you have to follow. First step, what you have to do? Write the given homogeneous differential equation. You have to write. That means any non-homogeneous differential equation will be given. You have to write its homogeneous part. Means you have to convert your right hand side equal to 0. That is known as homogeneous differential equation. For example, d square y by dx square plus 5 dy by dx plus 6y equal to sin x, then its homogeneous equation is d square y by dx square plus 5 dy by dx plus 6y equal to 0. Okay, so from the question you can write your homogeneous differential equation. Then write the auxiliary equation. You know, already you have discussed in our homogeneous part that how can you write the auxiliary equation. So you have to write that. Then after, solve it for d. You have to solve your auxiliary equation to find the value of d. And those are known as root, and find the roots. Find CF or YC. By using the roots, you have to go for the cases of CF. So if the roots will match to the such cases, means there are three cases are there. Okay, so according to the cases, you have to write your CF. Then after, you have to find the PI. Okay, so these are the procedure. You have to find out the PI. Then final answer is, complete solution is y equal to CF plus PI, or sometimes we write y equal to YC plus YP, both having same meaning. CF means YC, PI means YP, clear? So then come to rules of finding particular integral. In our previous class, we have completed how to find CF, okay, so similar process you will find CF. So now you have to know about the procedure how to find PI. So PI means the formula will be that non-homogeneous linear differential equation is dn plus p1 dn minus 1 d to the power n minus 1 plus dotted up to pn y equal to capital X. So this is known as non-homogeneous, and this is in operator form. So after taking common y, so we write this bracket term as f of d, means function of d, means polynomial in d. So f of d y equal to capital X. That implies y equal to 1 by f of d of capital X. Clear? And this is the formula for your PI. Clear? So now we write in place of y, it is known as yp, because x is now your capital X is using here. Okay? But in case of CF, this will become 0. Clear? But in case of PI, this must be used in your formula. So PI equals to YP equal to PI equal to 1 by f of d of capital X. This is your formula for PI. So there are different cases to find PI depending upon X. So what are those? So all of you remember PI equals to 1 by f of d of capital X. Okay. So there are four cases. Case 1, to find the value of PI. Means that depends upon capital X, means sometimes in your right hand side capital X equals to maybe e to the power x, maybe sine cos, maybe x to the power something. Okay, so for particular function there is a particular case. So when capital X equals to e to the power x, e to the power x, so at that time your PI formula is PI or YP equal to 1 by f of d of capital X, and here capital X is e to the power x, so you write e to the power x. Put, what you have to do? You have to collect this a, it will be denoted as d equal to a, and if so, for example, e to the power 2x means a is 2, so we have to put d equal to 2. Where you will put means in your denominator, means in f of t you have to put. Okay, so likewise you will complete. So what is the second line? Then yp equals to 1 by a, it will becomes f of a e to the power x, provided that f of a not equal to 0. If it is 0 means doesn't exist. Means we have to go for, means your rule fails. So you write if f of a equals to 0, rule fails, then find first derivative of f of t, means f of t derivative you have to find out, and put d equal to a in f dash t. Okay, so then your answer will becomes yp equal to x into, you have to multiply x into 1 by f dash t e to the power x, if denominator becomes 0. Okay, only this will happen, then you have to go for this process, x into 1 by f dash t e to the power x. So similarly, this is again your case 1 is continuing, e to the power means again you have to put d equal to a here. So that means you will write f dash of a x into 1 by f dash of a e to the power x. Again this will become 0, again if f dash t equal to 0, again your rule fails, that means find second derivative of f of d, then you write yp equal to x square. One time derivative means multiply x, two times derivative means multiply x into x, so x square into 1 by f double dash t e to the power x, and so on. So on means if your denominator becomes 0, that means you will continue like this process, but maximum question you have to go for this. Either sometimes you will find here, means after putting the value of d equals to a in your f of d, you will get your result. Sometimes in some question you will face your rule fails. Okay, so at that time you have to go for to find the derivative of f of t. Clear? So the, using the example, by taking the example, you can clear about this case. So this is your one example. Solve d square plus 5d plus 6 whole into y equals to e to the power x. So this is a non-homogeneous differential equation. Clear? So its solution is y equals to yc plus yp. Yes or no? So first of all, you have to write the question. So solution is y equals to yc plus yp, means you have to find out cf, then after you have to find out pi. Okay, so cf means or yc. So cf means you have to write your right hand side equal to 0, d square plus 5d plus 6 whole into y equal to 0, I am writing here. After that you have to write your auxiliary equation. Auxiliary equation means this y you delete, and the bracket term that equals to 0, this is your auxiliary equation. Okay, so by solving this auxiliary equation you will get the value of d. So you can have your formula, Sridharacharya formula, to solve quadratic equation, or you can use this Middleton factorization method. So you will get, by solving this you will get d equals to minus 3 comma minus 2. So these are the root. As we have discussed, CF can be written depends upon the roots. If your roots are unequal, then there is a formula. If your roots are equal, there is another formula. If your root is a complex number, there is another formula. Clear? So this is of case 1 of CF, minus 3 minus 2. So case 1 CF formula is y equals 2 yc, that equals to c1 e to the power m1s, means m1 is minus 3, so c1 e to the power minus 3s plus c2 e to the power minus 3s. So this is all about CF. Complete? So then we will go to find the PI. CF completed, then come to PI. PI means same thing, formula 1 by f of d of capital X. You have to write again, first of all, 1 by f of d of capital X, that equals to, what is your f of d? Our f of d is this one, d square plus 5d plus 6. So you have to use your d square plus 5d plus 6. So what is your capital X? You can see from your question, capital X is e to the power x. So means right hand side function. Okay, so we are putting here e to the power x, that equals to, this is of case 1. As your case 1 is saying that you collect your a, that is present in the coefficient of x, means here a is 1. Okay, so a equal to 1 means d equal to 1 you have to put here. So in place of d you put 1, means 1 square, that is 1, 5 into 1, that is 5, plus 6 e to the power x. So finally we are getting 1 by 12 e to the power x. Clear? So this is not equal to 0, means our phase is, our rule is success. So this is your final answer. Okay, so 1 by 12 e to the power x. So we have obtained our PI, and previously we have obtained our CF. So final solution is, complete solution is y equals to yc plus yp, or CF plus PI equal to, so yc, c1 e to the power minus 3s plus c2 e to the power minus 2s plus yp means this is your yp 1 by 12 e to the power x. Clear all of you? So this is all about your solution of non-homogeneous linear differential equation. Complete? Similarly, another case, that is case 2, when your capital X equal to sin ax plus b or cos ax plus b, means right hand side function is either sin or cos. Okay, so at that time PI formula is 1 by f of d of capital X. This is your formula, that equals to 1 by f of d of sin x plus b. So you have to collect a will be present and which is the coefficient of x. So you have to collect a, and here the formula is different. Formula, what is your formula? D square equals to, you have to put d square equals to minus a square. You have to put this one. But in case of case 1 means whenever your capital X is e to the power a, so at that time you are putting d equals to a only. But here d square equals to minus a square. This is your formula, you have to remember. Okay, so you are writing 1 by f of d square sin x plus b. There are other terms are present also, but our focus only for d square. That's why I am writing f of d square. Clear? So d square equals to, it will be by putting, so it will becomes f of minus a square sin ax plus b. Clear? After that, if your answer, you are getting your answer, then stop here. If your denominator becomes 0, then your case is failure. Okay, so at that time the same thing, you have to multiply x and you have to find the derivative of f of d. Means f of d is present will be here, you have to find the derivative of f of d, you write here, then again you apply. Okay, so let us check in our example. Solve y double dash plus 4y dash plus 4y equal to 3 sin s plus 4 cos x. This is your formula. So it is clear in front of you that this is a non-homogeneous linear differential equation. Okay, so given equation in symboling form is d square plus 4d plus 4 of y equals to 3 sin s plus 4 cos x. So here this is a non-homogeneous equation, that means we have to find the CF and we have to find the PI. So let us start to find CF. CF means we have to write the homogeneous part of the given differential equation. Homogeneous part means your right hand side becomes 0. So we are writing 0. Then we have to write this auxiliary equation. Then we solve this equation. We are getting the value of d minus 2 minus 2. Okay, so these are the roots, and according to the, though you are finding CF, you have to follow your case. Which case is this? This is your case 2, means roots are real and equal. So if your roots are real and equal, so there is a fixed formula. So you have to apply that formula. That is yc equals to c1 plus c2x. Whenever your roots are equal, the formula is yc equals to c1 plus c2x e to the power minus 2x. Clear? So CF complete, then come to PI. PI means or YP. 1 by f of d of capital X, so that equals to 1 by f of d, means your auxiliary equation left hand side, so this is the capital X. So though all the both the functions are sine and cos, and where a is 1, so here the case 2 means d square equals to minus a square, so minus 1 square, so that equals to minus 1. So only in place of d square you have to put minus 1. So here d square present here. Okay, so don't touch to d term. Okay, so for case 2 you have to remember only you have to your focus is for d square, not for d. Okay, so others will be written as usual. So d square is minus 1, because we are getting here minus 1 plus 4d plus 4 of 3 sin s plus 4 cos x, that equals to 1 by 4d, then 4 minus 1 is plus 3 of 3 sin s plus 4 cos x. Then after, what we'll do, again we can see this is our case 2 function, means sin or cos. Case 2 means we need d square term, but in your denominator d square term is absent. Okay, so we have to create d square term. How can we create? So we have to multiply, means 4d plus 3, we have to go for rationalization method. Means if some factor will be there, we have to multiply both in numerator its opposite factor. Means 4d plus 3 present, you have to multiply 4d minus 3 both in numerator and in the denominator. Why we are multiplying? Because we know a square minus b square formula is a plus b into a minus b. So a plus b present, we have to multiply a minus b. or 3 sin x plus 4 cos x. Then the denominator will be cos by using the formula a plus b into a minus b equals to a square minus b square. So here a is 4d, means 4d square, that is 4 square is 16, d square minus b square means 3.